Good afternoon, everyone. We are gathered here today in the sight of God and in this company of witnesses to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony. This sacred relationship of marriage was established by God in creation. Our Lord Jesus adorned marriage by his presence and first miracle at the wedding in Cana of Galilee. The Apostle Paul chose marriage to symbolize the union between Christ and his church, and Holy Scripture commends marriage to be honored among all people. The union of husband and wife in heart, body, and mind is intended by God for their mutual joy, for the help and comfort given to one another in prosperity and in adversity, and when it is the will of God, for the procreation of children and their nurture in the knowledge and love of our Lord. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but discreetly, soberly, and in the fear of God. I'm reading from Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verses 9 through 12. The scripture says, two are better than one because they have a good reward for their labor. For if they fall, the one will lift up his fellow, but woe to him that is alone when he falls, for he hath not another to help him up. Again, if two lie together, then they have heat, but how can one be warm alone? And if one prevails against him, two shall withstand him, and a threefold cord is not quickly broken. I'm going to ask you to join hands for me as you face each other. Each other in the eye of that hands.
Brian, go on top.
Brian, you're taking the woman whom you hold by the hands to be your lawful and wedded wife. Do you promise before God and these witnesses to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep you only unto her so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Erica, you're taking the man whom you hold by the hands to be your lawful and wedded husband, do you promise before God and these witnesses to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep you only unto him so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Yes.
Our Lord taught us that at the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this cause, a man shall leave his father and his mother and shall cleave to his wife in the building of a home, and the two shall become one flesh. I'm going to ask you to repeat your vows after me. Begin with you, sir. I, Brian, look at the I now.
I, Brian.
Take you, Erica.
Take you, Erica.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
As God is my witness.
As God is my witness.
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
Likewise, Erica. I, Erica.
I, Erica.
Take you, Brian.
Take you, Brian.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better and for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
For sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
As God is my witness.
As God is my witness.
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
The Word of God describes the kind of love we are to have each for the other. It says love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous. Love does not brag and is not arrogant. Does not act unbecomingly. Does not seek its own. Is not easily provoked. Does not take into account a wrong suffered. Does not rejoice in unrighteousness, but rejoices with the truth. Bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love.
So gorgeous.
Never end. And such should be the love that you have for each other. May I have the rings, please?
Right, you hand it to...
Nope. Oh.
Perfect.
They got it.
From ancient times, rings have been used to seal important covenants. Throughout the years, rings have become a symbol of wedded love. Mm. The wedding rings serve as an outward sign of a deeply personal and a sacred inner relationship. They serve as a reminder of your commitment one to the other. May you wear them as a symbol of your love for each other. Bless, O Lord, these rings to be a sign of the vows by which this man and this woman have bonded together in the holy relationship of marriage. Amen. Will you take the ring for me? And Harry, will you extend your left hand? Look her in the eye and repeat after me, please. Erica, I give you this ring.
Erica, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
Put it all the way for me.
So smooth.
Likewise, Erica. Brian, you extend your left hand. Just put it after his finger. The eye would be that for me, please. Brian, I give you this ring.
Brian, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
With all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
Put it all together.
Squeeze around.
Brian and Erica, may the Lord bless you in this your new life together. May he prosper you in all that you set your hearts to do. May the Lord be gracious unto you and grant you his peace. Having heard the vows you have just made to each other, witnessed by these persons present, by the power vested in me as a minister of the gospel, and according to the laws of these United States Virgin Islands, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. Cartwright.
Let there be you, let there be me, let there be oysters under the sea, let there be wind, an occasional rain, chili con carne, and sparkling champagne. Let there be birds to sing in the trees, someone to bless me whenever I sneeze. Let there be cuckoos, a lark and a dove, but first of all, please, let there be love. Let there be love. Let there be love. Let there be love.
Right up. Gotta have Gary in
trees, someone to bless me whenever I sneeze. Let there be cuckoos, a lark and a dove. But first of all, please let there be love. Let there be love. Let there be love. Let there be love.